Anyways.
Hey, hi, hello, and welcome back. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Claudia. I am a 23-year-old living in Brooklyn, New York, and I'm interested in sexology and trauma-informed therapy. I'll give you guys a little update on my life. What did I do? It's Saturday. It's a gorgeous day out right now. I'm sitting here and I'm like, fuck, I can't wait to be outside. But I needed to sit my ass down and actually make a video because I have been trying to make this video for like a month now. And the only person that's holding myself back is me. It is a Saturday. Last night I went to an incredible show. The band is called Libidinal. You can follow them on Instagram. Today I wanted to talk to you guys about something that is near and dear to my heart, but also is the cause for so much pain in my life. And that is medication, specifically SSRIs, and the ways in which SSRIs have, for lack of a better word, fucked my sex life up completely. I'm feeling less depressed thanks to these SSRIs, but I'm certainly feeling more sexually repressed. Let's dive in.
This is your brain. This is drugs. This is your brain on drugs.
So we'll start with what the fuck SSRIs even are. SSRI stands for Selective Serotonin Reuptake Inhibitor. These little guys. So as the name would suggest, SSRIs target serotonin. Now serotonin is a neurotransmitter, or also known as like a chemical messenger in your brain, that is attributed to positive mood. So we have seven main neurotransmitters in our brain, and you've probably heard of a lot of these. There's dopamine, there's adrenaline, oxytocin, which is known as like the attachment neurotransmitter, and serotonin. There's quite a few more, but I don't know how to pronounce them, but I will put them right here. So these are the seven main neurotransmitters that happen in the brain-body connection. So the thing about SSRIs is that they don't actually produce any serotonin. Serotonin doesn't actually cross the brain-blood barrier, which means that the brain must produce whatever serotonin is occurring in the body. Therefore, SSRIs don't actually produce serotonin themselves. So you're not taking an SSRI and immediately having serotonin enter into your body from the exterior. Instead, it's helping the body produce more serotonin naturally. So when you have more serotonin in your body, you're going to have less symptoms that are attributed to clinical depression and will probably have a better chance of responding positively to other forms of treatment such as talk therapy. In the late 1960s, evidence began to emerge that suggested a significant role in serotonin in MDD, which is major depressive disorder, also known as clinical depression. As a result, the pharmaceutical company Eli Lilly began developing ligands. I'm gonna be saying a lot of medical terms that I honestly don't really know how to pronounce, so y'all are just gonna have to stick with me. As a result, the pharmaceutical company Eli Lilly began developing ligands that would selectively inhibit the reuptake of serotonin at serotonin transporters. The FDA, in December of 1987, approved fluoxetine, and this was launched to the market in January of 1988 under the trade name Prozac, followed by the introduction of Zoloft in 1991 and Paxil in 1992. So SSRIs are mainly prescribed to treat depression, but they can also be used to treat general anxiety disorder, obsessive compulsive disorder, panic disorder, phobias, bulimia, and PTSD. So why does this affect libido? You would think that with serotonin being kept in your body and having a higher level of serotonin, that therefore you would be more responsive to things that would essentially give you pleasure. It is worthy to note that about 35 to 50% of people who have an untreated major depression disorder experience some type of sexual dysfunction prior to the treatment. Sexual dysfunction can be described as a low sexual desire, such as low libido, arousal difficulties, which is a lack of lubrication, and anorgasmia, which is the inability to orgasm after frequent and consistent sexual stimulation. Here, it is important for me to note the distinction between a libido and arousal. Libido is driven by desire, so this means it's the urge to have sex, the drive to have sex. You are horny, you are like, I want to fuck right now. Whereas arousal is the physical response to sexual stimulant. So think back to in middle school, if you have a penis, you probably would randomly get boners and you're like, I'm not even horny right now. I'm not turned on, but I'm being aroused. You're not necessarily having desire, but you're having an arousal response. Back to what I was saying, 35 to 50% of people who have an untreated major depression experience some type of sexual dysfunction prior to treatment. However, even if you get treatment, such as getting put on SSRI, you might find that sexual dysfunction is still affecting you.
Zoloft is not for everyone. People taking medicines called MAOI shouldn't take Zoloft. Side effects may include dry mouth, insomnia, sexual side effects,
diarrhea, nausea, and sleepiness.
I asked people on my Instagram if they had any experiences with a lack of sexual desire after having an SSRI. Most of you said yes. Some of you said no. And for that, good for you. This video is not for you. Just kidding, if you're watching it, you can still stay, but this is for all of the people who cannot come for the life of them. According to the National Center for Biotechnology Information, the effects of SSRIs on sexual functioning seem strongly dose-related and may vary among the group according to serotonin and dopamine reuptake mechanisms, induction of prolactin release, anticholinergic effects, inhibition of nitric oxide synthase, and propensity for acclimation over time. So what the fuck does any of that mean? The effects of SSRIs on sexual dysfunction cannot necessarily be pinned down. Unfortunately, there is not a ton of research that pinpoints why SSRIs specifically affect libido and arousal, because there are so many factors that could play into the reasons why you're having trouble getting aroused and finishing. They can't necessarily claim it's this one thing. It can be, are you feeling anxious or depressed in your relationship? Are you stressed? Is the medication dose too high for you? Is this the wrong medication for you? There are so many different factors and variants that could be at play, so we can't necessarily make a specific claim as to why SSRIs are affecting libido. They try to, and I came across this insane infographic. When I looked at it, I was like, I don't understand academia, because how could someone put this together? And they were like, yep, this is it. This is the good one. This makes sense. So all of that to say, you're here, you're taking SSRIs, and you want to be able to have a fruitful and fulfilling sex life. Where do we go from here? So there's a few options, and these are suggested from an array of sources that I will put in the description below. Now, obviously, I am not a professional, I am not a psychiatrist, and therefore all of these options should be done with professional medical supervision. Lowering the dose might have, to a certain degree, an effect on whether or not you are feeling the effects of kind of like a numbness or a lack of desire. It kind of becomes a feedback loop, because if you're taking SSRIs, as I had mentioned previously, you're going to be more open and probably have a more positive response to other forms of treatment, such as talk therapy. So if you are in talk therapy and you're taking your SSRIs, you have a support system in place where lowering the dose doesn't necessarily put you at risk, because you still have this form of support and talk therapy. Lowering doses, I will say, is much easier and less scary, personally, in my experience, than I had assumed. I will jump into my personal history with SSRIs. So when I first started my freshman year of college, I had just 2 months prior started to become sexually active with my boyfriend at the time, and I was struggling with some pretty debilitating depression and anxiety. I had just moved to New York, I was starting college, I didn't know anybody in the city, and I was just feeling insanely overwhelmed. It was the expectation to be autonomous as a college student, it was being in a city that I knew literally no one, and I was feeling the weight of the distance between myself and my boyfriend and all my high school friends, all my family. I felt lost. I felt like I didn't really know where to go. I'd been in and out of therapy since 2012, but this was the first time that I was kind of able to take my own mental health journey into my own hands, and I decided to take the first steps towards managing my anxiety and depression with medication. So I found a psychologist and a psychiatrist in New York City, and I went on 25 milligrams of sertraline, which is another name for Zoloft. So I stayed on Zoloft, and I briefly tried fluoxetine, which, if you recall earlier, is the medical name for Prozac. But I experienced sedation, which was not a super common side effect, but it was one that was listed and could be felt in severe instances. My instance was severe, unfortunately, so I hopped back to Zoloft because I found that the pros outweighed the cons when it comes to symptoms. So I've steadily increased my dosage of Zoloft since 2016, and I've been consistently taking about 100 milligrams now since 2017, which essentially matches the expanse of time that I've been sexually active. So my entire adult sexual life has been on an SSRI, which is crazy to think about. It kind of leads me to think, have I ever actually experienced sex before? And I know that might sound hyperbolic, but I don't know what it's like to have sex off of medication. And I have found that I have a really hard time having a high libido or reaching orgasm. And it's hard because it puts a lot of strain on yourself and think like, is something wrong with me? Like, why can't I do this? It gets so frustrating, and it adds a strain to your relationships as well. If you're in a relationship, any type of relationship with a partner, it's hard for the partner to not think that it's them. To have to feel like you have to justify the fact that you have a low libido is also a really painful and an unfair place to be put in. And it's difficult to navigate for both the person on the medication and the person who is having sex with someone who's on the medication. It kind of becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy at that point. You are experiencing anxiety or depression, you go on an SSRI and are seeking treatment to aid and hopefully decrease the symptoms of said anxiety and depression. You are faced with sexual dysfunction as a result of said anxiety and depression, and the SSRIs might not necessarily be helping that. Therefore, you aren't able to have an intimate and physical, pleasurable experience having sex, which will make you feel anxious or make you feel depressed. So where do we go from here? The sources that I will provide in the description below have essentially all suggested the same options when it comes to treating a sexual dysfunction as a symptom of an SSRI slash a symptom of anxiety and depression. Now, I obviously want to preface this by saying I am in no way an expert. I am just a girl who looks things up. Any of these options that you would like to take, you should 100% do them with the guidance of a medical professional. A psychiatrist's whole job is to ensure that you have a safe experience with medication. That being said, a lot of them, you know, it's big pharma, so they might just get paid for business. That's neither here nor there. Here are a few of the options, and I'll go into each of them in a little more depth. So you can lower the dose. You can schedule sex. You can do something called a drug holiday. And you can also look into switching to a different drug. So we'll start with lowering the dose. It's pretty self-explanatory. You would lower your dosage if things worsen, and lowering the dose is not necessarily your best bet. You can move on to some of the other options. So sometimes switching to a different medication can help. Certain medications have been reported to have less of an effect on sexual function than others. I know that Wellbutrin is a medication that is kind of colloquially spoken about as helping with libido, and I say helping not to mean that it's increasing your sex drive, but it's just not depleting it. You will want to be sure to have support systems in place when you're making these changes. Scheduling sex. So this one kind of goes hand in hand, I personally think, with drug holiday. And when I first saw drug holiday, I was like, what the fuck is this? It sounds like something that I would never hear come out of a doctor's mouth. Upon looking further into it, it actually seems like a really viable option, especially if you're a little nervous about lowering the dose or going on a different medication, if that is something that makes you anxious. This is where like chemistry would really help in me. talking about this. So I will say that in the studies that discuss a drug holiday, all the study sizes were rather small, and there is a lack of randomization and a lack of new studies. So again, don't take my word for it. Do not take this as medical advice. However, this is something that you can bring up to your psychiatrist or medical practitioner. Essentially, taking a drug holiday, let's say it is a Thursday morning, you don't take your Thursday morning dose of your SSRI, and you don't take your dose for the SSRI until the following Sunday morning. So the SSRI, depending on the dose that you're taking, will remain in your system. So you will not have a significant increase in depressive symptoms. However, you might have a improvement in sexual functioning. So in this particular study that I am referencing, it was 30 outpatients. And for 4 weekends in a row, they did this drug holiday. There was a significant improvement in sexual functioning reported by 60% of the patients taking sertraline, 50% taking paroxetine, but only 10% taking fluoxetine, the Prozac one. In all three of these, the improvement was greater in men than it was for women. There was no significant increase in depression scores, which is to say that there was no increase in depressive symptoms. This might allow for a significant improvement in sexual functioning. What do we take away from all that? If you are experiencing some type of sexual dysfunction or low libido, and you are either having symptoms of depression or anxiety, or you are taking SSRIs, you are not alone at all. It is extremely normal, albeit unfortunate, but it is not something that is uncommon. The main takeaway that I can give as someone who is not in a medical field is that it can be hard to feel as though you are letting down either yourself or a partner by not having a high sex drive or by not feeling like you can achieve orgasm. However, there are options, both in talk therapy and medically speaking, to improve your sexual function. The main step, and this is kind of why I'm making this video, is to start talking about it. There is a lot of shame around being a sexual person, but on the other hand, there is a lot of shame as well in feeling like you cannot be a viable sexual partner, or you just cannot experience sexual pleasure even though you want to. That shame is eventually going to just compile upon itself. You will not be entering into any sexual experience with the right headspace and mindset that will allow you to be free and fully let yourself feel and experience the pleasure and sensations that are happening to you, because you will be so in your head about it. I cannot urge you enough to talk about it, to explain to them if you are not feeling like you're in the mood, if you are not feeling turned on, because even if you don't have the answers, and even if they don't have the answers, it puts on the table the fact that you know that there might be a factor that is affecting your libido that is not them, and it's also not you. And I say that with the grace and understanding that it can be hard to identify yourself as your mental illness and to consider that your mental illness is like your identity. So it's like, oh, I'm depressed and I'm having this sexual dysfunction, so therefore the problem is me. But it's not. It's an unfortunate circumstance, but it is one that can be treated and isn't forever. Well, thank you for watching this video. I realize this one is going to be rather long, so if you made it this far, I really appreciate it. I'm kind of toying with doing like longer form videos. If that's something that you would be interested in, please let me know. You can follow me on Instagram at @reversecowgirl. You can like and subscribe to this channel. I would very much appreciate it, because I love doing this, even if I'm not doing it frequently. I am looking forward to talking with you all next time.